vessel is intact. In fact, it's really one of the few remaining military structures made of wood that's intact of this era. This is like an original floating fort, a radeau, completely intact. But this is an American ship. It was built by American shipwrights. And has every right to, you know, make a claim as the oldest intact warship in North America.
She has two mast steps, 13 oar holes per side, made out of wood, and you can see the rocks were used inside to help sink it. And there it is. Had some structural damage from a downrigger fishing weight that hit it. And because of all our efforts, we've come up with over 30 drawings. So this disappears, we can build a replica of it. And then we ran into all sorts of problems. Okay, archaeology's done. Now the cultural resource management comes into play. We had a ship modeler who would build models for us. And then because of that, an animator was able to take this, photograph it, take measurements, and then create this wonderful animation that is needed to tell these stories using documentaries. His name is John Weitzel, the documentaries. We also did a photo mosaic. And back in the 80s and early 90s, photo mosaics, you take a shot of this, move over, you overlap, take another shot, and you get out your scotch tape. And then one day, 1993, a guy said, hey, there's this new software. It's called Photoshop. It just came out. I think I can do it. I've talked to Princeton University. We'll go down and we'll create a photo mosaic and we'll put this together. 1,000 hours later,
wow,
we came up with the first photo mosaic of this shipwreck right here. Okay. And we could probably now do that in a couple of days, but that was a very interesting project. We had a grant for about $2,500 to do that. A lot of sweat equity went into it. So we decided to put this into an underwater park as a way of managing diving on it. And we built a ring around the radeau. Let's catch it right here. We didn't hire a team to come up with that. We used PVC pipes and so forth. So divers come down. This is the scale. The boat comes up here. They go down 107 feet. They can go around and so forth and be able to see something that's quite unique. We get about 150 divers a year that visit this site. It's in deep water. It's 107 feet down. You have to have a permit to dive it. But this hopefully will minimize any type of destruction to this very rare warship. So rare that it's only one of six shipwrecks in American waters.